And now, it is my great pleasure to introduce Governor Gina Raimondo. Governor, we appreciate your efforts last year in support of several of the coalition's key priorities. You championed raising the minimum wage, which increased to $10.10 on January 1st, and will increase again next January to $10.50. You helped making working families by making permanent the child care exit income, which allows parents to continue to receive child care assistance as their income rises. You have consistently supported early learning opportunities by increasing the state's pre-kindergarten and Head Start program, as well as the child care assistance program. You supported the restoration of funds for the free bus pass for seniors and people with disability. We appreciate all that you do, and we look forward to continuing to work together this year to ensure that no Rhode Islander lives in poverty.
Thank you, Maxine. Thank you, all of you, for being here, members of the clergy and activists and members of the community. Thank you for being here. I want to recognize a few other people, most especially the Senate President. He and his team in the Senate have been great partners to me over the past few years. And Maxine mentioned the restoration of the ripped bus passes. The Senate President was a leader on that, and together we were able to really make that happen. I also want to recognize quickly some of my colleagues, the Treasurer. We're working together on the school construction project. We want to alleviate poverty. Let's get kids in schools that are safe and secure and warm. Our Secretary of State, who is doing a terrific job, also the Mayor of Providence, who is here. He is a great partner to us. We're working very hard together to improve the economy and, as Maxine says, make sure nobody's left behind. I can't believe you've been at this for 10 years. This is the 10th one of these. This is, I guess, my fourth. I've come each year that I've been governor. For me, it's like the official beginning of the new year, and it's the right place to begin because it sets your conscience where it needs to be. And so for me, I look forward to it. I always come here and I ask you for your prayers. I ask you for your prayers that we do have the wisdom to do the right thing and the courage to do the right thing and to stand up for what's right, which isn't always easy. So thank you for being here. Thank you for being principled. Thank you for your advocacy and for your humility. As I look around the room, I know so many of you, those of you who are leading parishes, those of you who work in the trenches and social services, and for very little money in most cases, and you do it for all the right reasons, and you make Rhode Island stronger. And so I love to be here and support you in all the ways that I can. Maxine's right, I've been very proud to be the governor. I'm told I'm the only governor ever who's put three budgets in a row calling for an increase in the minimum wage. And I think that's important. Working together over the past 3 years, we've raised the minimum wage, brought about all-day kindergarten, we've tripled the number of pre-K classrooms, we've increased compensation for child care workers, we've improved investments in Head Start. I was proud to stand up for the DACA kids this year. They belong here in Rhode Island. I'm proud to welcome Syrian refugees to Rhode Island. We're going to keep our doors open despite all that's going on around us. I do continue to support driver's licenses for undocumented immigrants and would love the legislature to send a law to my desk that I could sign to make that happen. And I do support the efforts Maxine just talked about increasing wages for child care workers and so that folks can go get a job, and continuing to invest in job training so people can get a job. Last year, we also together took a huge step forward, making CCRI tuition free. Many people here helped with that effort. You should know that that because of that, we've had a 45% increase in the number of kids going to CCRI. And you want to know their story? If you talk to one of them, you talk to all of them. It's all the same version of the story, which is, I couldn't be going to college without this. They're all working full-time, going to college full-time, and this is their only ticket to a decent job.
Amen.
By the way, many of them are immigrants, first in their family to go to college. Many of them have been immigrants, their family have been immigrants. These aren't people who want a handout. These are people who want a ticket out of poverty to have a chance to get a good job. So I'm proud of the work that we've done together. You know, Rhode Island is absolute. A few years ago, we had the highest unemployment rate in America, and now with the winds at our back, our unemployment rate has fallen. There's momentum, but still, too many people are in poverty. A lot of people are feeling. A lot of people are feeling economic resurgence. I got a good job, I got a raise, and that's great. But you know what? We're not going to stop till everybody's feeling it, because too many people are left out. So I begin the year thanking you for what you do, recommitting myself to public service and to the people of Rhode Island, and keep us honest, and we'll keep working hard for everybody. So thank you, and God bless. By the way, I'm going to excuse myself to go get ready for snow preparation. Now, I have to tell you this. This is going to be a doozy. Stay home tomorrow, please. Look in on a neighbor. Please, please help somebody get to a warming shelter on Friday or Saturday if they lose power. It's going to be brutal. We're going to get through it. Let us know what you need. Say a lot of prayers, everybody. And don't try to be a hero. Just stay home and take it easy for a couple days and we'll get through it. Thank you.